and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Today in the Gospel reading, Jesus speaks the parable of the sower, the most well-known of all his parable teachings. And we think of the way in which the seed falls into the ground, dies, and bears fruit. And we think of the ways in which our own lives, threatened and challenged by recent circumstances, may fruit at this time of new opportunity, of renewed friendships and family contacts, of new opportunities and requests to meet the needs of those who suffer most. So, as those who worship God and follow Christ, we acknowledge that we must bear the seed, must speak the word, and must bear fruit in Christ's name. We do not always live up to these expectations. We often fail. The productivity of our fruitfulness is lacking. But we come to God aware of this and seeking his forgiveness as we pray together a prayer of penitence. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. sanctified. Hear our prayer which we offer for all your faithful people, that in their vocation and ministry they may serve you in holiness and truth to the glory of your name. Through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord: As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and succeed in the things for which I sent it. For shall go out in joy and be led back in peace. For the mountains and the hills before you shall burst into song, and all the trees on the field shall clap their hands. Instead of the thorn shall come up the cypress, instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle. And it shall be the Lord for a memorial, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. There is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set you free from the law of sin and death. For God has done what the law, weakened by the flesh, could not do. By sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and to deal with sin, he condemned sin in the flesh, so that the just requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit set their minds on the things of the Spirit. Set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace. For this reason, the mind that is set on the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law. Indeed, it cannot, and those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh. You are in the Spirit, since the Spirit of God dwells in you. Anyone who does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, though the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is life because of righteousness. If the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also through his Spirit that dwells in you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
They sprang up quickly, since they had no depth of soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched, and since they had no root, they withered away. Other seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. Other seeds fell on good ground, and brought forth grain, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. Let anyone with ears listen. Hear then the parable of the sower. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and doesn't understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what is sown in the heart. This is what was sown on the path. As for what was sown on rocky ground, this is the one who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet such a person has no root, but endures only for a while. And when trouble or persecution arises on account of the word, that person immediately falls away. As for what was sown among thorns, this is the one who hears the word, But the cares of the world and the lure of wealth choke the word, and it yields nothing. But as for what was sown on good soil, this is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields, in one case 100, in another 60, and in another 30. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Rhoda, my mum's carer, and my housekeeper, who read the first reading this morning, says that I have a green thumb. That's a way of saying green fingers, but in fact, lots of languages talk about a green thumb rather than the whole array of fingers. She says this because I bought some seeds from Sainsbury's for some sweet pea hanging baskets and some cosmos buckets. And we planted them in March and early April. We put them on a windowsill facing north, so not in direct sunlight. And every day we sprayed them with water in a cleaned out spray cleaner bottle so that the top of the surface of the planting remained moist 24 hours a day. They were on the windowsill of the stairs, and every time I went up and down the stairs in the day, about 7 or 8 times, I checked whether the top of the surface was moist and would spray if it wasn't. Well, the seeds sprouted, hence why Rhoda gave me the accolade of having the green thumb. But we followed the instructions and put them outside in the garden after 3 weeks. Now, this may be a lovely churchyard. It may have the fabulous Eden Community Garden and some wonderful allotments close by. And it may be full of bees producing honey, having gathered nectar. But it's also full of slugs and snails. And I'm afraid to say the cosmos buckets suffered disproportionately, eating away at more than half of the plants in one of the buckets. But I'm now going to claim my role as gardener. And under Rhoda's supervision, I replanted half from one bucket into the other so that we've got a fair spread. This is the first time I'll ever have grown some flowers from seed. I'm not really a gardener, and I don't think my thumb is all that green. But when I ask you, and I ask myself, to what extent I bear the fruit that God's word produces in me, how should I assess that? How should you assess that? Well, fortunately, it's not up to our power by any means to achieve this.
It's the indwelling of the Spirit of God, seeds of light, sparks of living hope that dwell within us through the inheritance that we've received of the Word of God preached through generation upon generation, that we are enabled to speak God's word of truth and love. Not our own ability, but God's ability and grace living within us. Part of the gospel reading this morning links together two passages from Matthew 13, leaving out the bit where the disciples show that they haven't understood what the parable of the sower meant at all. And we segue into the second part where Jesus explains it. But of course, we are too often like those disciples and not understanding how exactly we are going to bear fruit for God. Jesus used parables, he states specifically, so that people might hear and yet not understand. His disciples frequently showed their inability to comprehend. And I'd like to suggest that I certainly often fail in this understanding. And I know many of you do too at times. All of us do, sometimes. Therefore, taking courage in the words of the prophet Isaiah, to note that God's word does not go out to return without fruit. But in fact, when the presence of God's life and word are felt within the human community, the mountains and the hills break forth into song. The beauty of the world is glorified and affirmed, and God's creative power renewed. It's with great pleasure that I can announce, if you hadn't yet heard, that St. Paul's has received a bronze medal as part of the Green Church movement. We already, within the Lambeth Parks district, receive a green ecological flag which waves joyfully over our churchyard. But to work together to make our whole planet reflect God's goodness once again as it originally was meant to is something that faces our community today. Not just ours here, but all around the globe. But we won't do it in our own efforts. We'll do it by aligning ourselves to God's will and being inspired by God's word. The cosmos buckets and the sweet pea hanging baskets are just beginning to form flowers. Rhoda and I can't wait. We want to see the result of that green thumb. I want to see within myself and within you the productivity and creativity, the achievements that the Spirit can perform within us. Thanks be to God. Amen. We say together the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father.
Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the church and the world, and let us thank God for his goodness. Heavenly Father, we thank you that in the person of Jesus Christ you have taught us and sent out your word, and in the indwelling of the Spirit you sow those seeds that can transform us and the world. Help us to understand this. Help us to be your church, the body of Christ. Live in that word, so that that word may return to you fruitful. We pray for our Bishop Christopher and his suffragan Richard, for all those who lead the church. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for the nations of the world, that those who are elected or achieve office may come to understand the nature of God and of humanity, to work together for the good of all and for the good of the planet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for this community of St. Paul. We give thanks for the green element of our mission. We pray that it may be strengthened and enjoyed. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are sick in body, mind, or spirit, praying that the Spirit may comfort them. We remember Claire Bench, Sylvia Phillips, Claire Palmer, Samantha, Peggy Allen, and Josh Collins. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for the repose of the souls of the faithful departed, remembering Gareth Jones, who has died recently, and Geordie Williams, whose anniversary of death occurs at this time. Rest eternal, grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Rejoicing in the fellowship of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Paul, and all saints, we commend ourselves and all people to your merciful goodness. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possession. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
thank you.
kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Thank you. God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you.